In this video, I will show you how you can have array that are dynamic in size at runtime, just like malloc, but actually you don't have to free those. And also I will show you why you should actually almost never use this. So those are called variable length array, or VLAs. And the only difference between those arrays and the constant size array that that you usually have is that between the bracket when you declare them, you actually have a runtime variable instead of a constant number. So if you have a number like this, it's a constant array. Or if you declare a macro, length, like so, with a length here and use this macro here, this will be a constant size array, but if you use a regular variable for it, it will always be a variable length array. And those array resides on the stack. So when you exit the function, it will be automatically freed, unlike when you allocate an array with malloc. And if I execute this, you can see that it did what I wanted it. It created an array of length 12, initialized it with some values, and then printed those. And of course, you can change this to another value, and then you have a bigger array, except that the downside of this, since it's on the stack, instead of, so malloc allocates on the heap, which is much larger than the stack. The stack is where your local variables and your function calls reside, and those are supposed to be small, so that's why there is less space for the stack. And so if you abuse of this feature and put like a very large size, like so, let's say, which you could still allocate with malloc, I think, but if you do that with variable length array, as you can see, you just segfaulted. This is because the stack is small. So And I also say, yeah, that's mostly why you don't want to use them, and why I think there was I read a blog post about the Linux kernel finally getting rid of every single variable length array in the kernel or something like this, to make it much safer. Because, basically, if here length is a constant, as in I hard-coded it, but of course, if you determine the array length from user input or some other way, you're not in control of the size of this array, and that's why it could explode in your face, like so. And I think you're probably exposing yourself to some security issues as well, that wouldn't surprise me. But last little thing, just for your general knowledge, is that there is a thing called a function called allocA, which is has the same signature as malloc, but instead of allocating on the heap, it allocates on the stack. And so you could replace all this code let's make it slightly smaller now, but with so what you would do with malloc is you would do malloc length time size of int, like so. And then if you're a good boy, you free your stuff. Lib, like so. As you can see, it did what we expected, but actually you can use alloc A up and not free, but you have to import alloc A as well. And it did the same thing, but you don't have to free because it allocated this array on the stack. And I'm repeating myself, but again, you should never use this unless you have a very good reason why, or you're just prototyping something and you really don't care. Of course, the downside of this is you cannot return this from a function. So if you have a function called int pointer that foo that takes a length and actually returns this, you just like so, length. Maybe that will work out of luck, but I don't think so. As you can see, it did some very strange behavior, because when we return from the function, this allocation gets freed automatically. So so you can not use it outside of a function. So yeah, that's it about variable length array. Again, multiple warnings, don't use them, but they exist. And now if you find yourself on a bad tutorial, you can know what to do right. Anyway, see you.